how to create a blur on a bitmap layer. Now, over here, I have my Storyboard Pro project. I have my character coming in and skating on the eyes right here. And throughout the entire scene, he's actually standing on the ice. And I have his reflection right here in the ice. And this is actually what I would like to apply a blur to. Now, one of the first things that we need to know about applying blurs in Storyboard Pro is that those blurs can only be applied to a bitmap layer. Now, how can you see if you're using a bitmap layer? Well, first of all, the bitmap layers will always have a blue strip right here. Right now, I have gray strips on all of my layers. So how can I change my reflection to be a bitmap layer? Well, I can actually convert those really easily. One of the suggestions that I like to give people when they want to convert something is to first keep a copy of the original one. You've already drawn it in vector, so you don't necessarily want to lose that layer in case something happens. So you can really easily duplicate it from the button right here. So make sure you have the layer selected first and then go over here to the Duplicate Selected Layers button. Once we click on that, it creates a perfect copy of that selected layer. So we can hide the old one by just clicking on the eyes here. Since we have some opacity on that layer, we don't necessarily want to see both at the same time. Now, if I want to convert that layer into a bitmap layer, I need to right-click on it and go over to Convert to Bitmap Layer on this one. It's going to ask me how big I want this reflection to be. So right now I can just choose to keep it at the original setting. It's going to be fine. You want to be careful that it is big enough to include your selection. If part of your character disappears, it's probably because your canvas size is not big enough. So you want to make it big enough for it to include the art, but not so big that you would make it too big for it and then make your scene heavier, because bitmap layers tend to be a little bit more on the heavy side as opposed to vector layers, which are really light. So you want to take it easy on the size of the canvas. So I've converted my layer and we can see it from the blue strip here, which represent bitmap layers. And from here, I can just really easily right-click on it, go over to the last section, which will be grayed out if you're doing it on a vector layer, so really important, again, for the first step. And then we're going to go to Blur. So really simple over here. I have the radius of my blur. I'm going to keep it as 5 for now. And really important to know also, once we apply this effect, this will modify the drawing itself that's in here. So it's not an add-on that's added to the layer itself. It's really changing the drawing that's within the layer. So it's changed forever once it's in here. If you save and close your project, you're not going to be able to go back. So another reason why it's really good to have that duplicate layer, just in case something happens. So I pressed OK, and here we have it. I have my character that's blurred, and I'm ready to go and add it into all the other panels after that. Stay tuned for more info on the other types of blurs in Storyboard Pro.